to the Consciousness Anywhere and Everywhere podcast. I am Shannon O'Hara, and I invite you to a completely new world of possibilities.
Hello, everybody. So what's coming up on today's podcast is a little Halloween Facebook Live special I did on Halloween. I really wanted to create a Halloween-themed podcast this year, but my sort of date release for the podcast sort of fell either well before Halloween or well after. So we chose after, and what the hey, I think you're going to still enjoy it. It's a Talk to the Entities themed podcast, and there hasn't been very many of those. So I hope you enjoy it. I hope wherever you are listening to this, that you are being you. And let's see what's possible with a different perspective in the world. Enjoy.
Hello, everybody. I am currently in Puerto Vallarta, Mexico, doing a three-day body class. And I really want to show you the class, but like I'm not allowed to. So anyways, they're just all right there. So welcome to Talk to the Entities Halloween / Día de Muertos celebration. I hope all of you guys out there have been enjoying some awesome Facebook Lives with some of the awesome Talk to the Entities facilitators. We had some really, about 2 hours ago, I was like, what am I going to talk about on this? And I asked the class here, and there were some great questions. So I think my theme is, what were your two questions? How to be a witch? That was number one. And what was the other? There was like, what is Halloween kind of a thing? You know, and like these days we celebrate a lot of holidays and things that we don't necessarily we're no longer connected to their origins. And quite frankly, a lot of the holidays that we celebrate today were originally celestial or seasonal celebrations because our ancestors lived more in communion with the earth. So they were more celestial connected because they had to be. And both Día de Muertos and Halloween occur during the time of harvest when we're starting to enter into the darker time of the year in the Northern Hemisphere. So like today we celebrate mostly with food and candy, but what are the legends that brought us here and what were sort of the original sources of these celebrations and do they need to be relevant to you? We always do something for Halloween with Talk to the Entities because it is essentially the Talk to the Entities holiday. And I think the question of like how to be a witch in modern times is sort of an interesting one. I would say that in this day and age, no one would really call me a witch. They would more call me a bitch. So all you witches that turned into bitches, will you destroy it and create all that? Right, wrong, good, bad, all nine, pod, fox, shorts, boys, and beyonds. And all you bitches who really just want to be witches, but are super angry that you can't be the magic and the sorcery that you really are when you destroy it and create all that. Right, wrong, good, and bad, all nine, pod, pox, shorts, boys, and beyonds. So it's like, we have to remember that our ancestors all lived with, worked with, talked to, and believed in the spirit world. Lack of belief in the spirit world is a relatively modern phenomenon that was instituted by religion and then solidified by the religion of science. So we sort of live in this weird world now where you're like not really supposed to believe in ghosts, but like we all believe in ghosts. So we have like this dichotomy. And you have to remember, it's like our ancestors, like where Halloween / Día de Muertos / all of the harvest celebrations that have gone on through with all the cultures all over the world, call them whatever you want. They were essentially aware that the season was about to change and we were going from the time of warmth and light into the time of darkness. And I think that that going into the time of the darkness of the winter has been heavily misconstrued as like the darkness of the spirit world or the dark arts. Or the dark side of the moon, or you know, that stuff. And so how much of your connection with the earth that is the magic that then was accused of, that then was called witchcraft, have you given up because it's not acknowledged as a validity anymore? And everything that is, and everything that brings up, will you guys destroy and uncreate it, please? Right, Wrong, Good, Battle, Nine, Pod, Poc, Shorts, Boys, Beyonds. And like, what if this time of year, instead of celebrating the dead or celebrating the ghosts, like in America, it's all ghosts and goblins and ghouls and guts. And it's sort of like the one day of the year that like the dark side is allowed to come out. I remember we were in Santa Barbara, California, about 4 and maybe 5 years ago for Halloween. And I'm from Santa Barbara, but I hadn't lived in Santa Barbara for many, many, many years. So I was sort of back there for the first time in a really, really long time. And it was on Halloween and we were staying downtown and I didn't know it was Halloween. And I was walking around in the morning and there were people literally walking around with monsters masks on. And there was like dead bodies on lawns. And I was like, whoa, this is weird. And I was like, oh, it's Halloween. Isn't it interesting that that's the one time a year that people will let the dark side come out? And what if we didn't have to hide the dark side? No, let's do this instead. How much of your magic, mystery, possibility, and energy have you hidden in the dark so no one would judge you for it? And everything that is, you guys destroy and create it. Right, Wrong, Good, Battle, Nine, Pod, Poc, Shorts, Boys, Meons. And what humanoid capacities have been so heavily judged that you believe that if you're ever that capacity, that ability, that healing, that knowing, that energy ever again, you'll be, you know, condemned as being evil or a witch or both and everything that is, you guys destroy it and create it. And everywhere you perpetrated the curse of witchcraft too, will you destroy and uncreate all that? Right, Wrong, Good, Bad, All Nine, Pud, Puck, Shirts, Boys and Beyonds. And so like when we talk about witchcraft, it can go so many different ways because like either we laugh like, ha ha ha, funny witchcraft, right? Because in this day and age, we don't really talk about witchcraft as like a thing. But remember how like women used to be killed for witchcraft? And something I joke around about a lot today is like, I mean, look, it's like I talk to ghosts for a living. Like, what is that? If that's not witchcraft, I don't know what to call that. Crazy? Like you can either be a witch, you could be crazy, or you can be filthy rich. And what I would like to teach all of the witch bitches is how to be wildly famous and filthy rich for what is different about you that you think is wrong about you. And everything that is and everything that doesn't allow it, will you all please destroy and create it? Right and wrong, good and bad, all nine. Pod, Poc, Shorts, Boys and Beyonds. We have to come out of the dark ages where witchcraft was condemned and recognize that we are in a different day and age where witches can be rich. And no one really condemns you for witchcraft anymore because nobody believes in it. So we're pretty much free now. I want to send out a notice, like, they might have killed you that lifetime, but did you ever really lose you? So what magic, mystery, possibility, and spirit art craft are you capable of and does come naturally to you that if you chose it would change your life, your reality, and the reality around you? Everything that doesn't allow that, will you destroy and uncreate it, please? Right and wrong, good and bad, all nine, Pud, Puck, Shorts, Boys, Beyonds. If you were on this Facebook Live and you don't understand what that weird thing I just said was, that's the Access Consciousness Clearing Statement. I think if you're here, you probably know what Access is, but if you're ever watching this sometime in the future out there in the universe, somebody is going to post a link to theclearingstatement.com, wherever this video lives, and go please check that out. It's the magical erase button for all the energy you use to limit yourself. Whew. Okay, so what else, guys? Since I'm in Mexico, I'm going to probably take the track of Día de Muertos, which is basically an ancestral celebration. So most indigenous cultures still do ancestral celebrations. We have lost that in a lot of the Western Anglo cultures. We don't do ancestral celebrations. We pretend like once you die, then you're like gone forever. But in more indigenous cultures and more not traditional, native cultures, there's still a lot of ancestral worship and ancestral relevance, like Mexico, Africa, all of Asia, basically everywhere that is not a European descent culture. So all of the ancestors that have just come into the room and all of your ancestors that are out there with you guys, it's like, this is the talk to the entities point of view. So you have to remember, like, I grew up in a Western European descent culture. I didn't have actually any relationship with my grandparents that were alive, let alone my ancestors before them. Both of my biological parents basically ran away from their families. So I didn't have a really strong family connection, let alone ancestral connection. So when I first started working with entities, it was like, okay, what do I do with this awareness rather than just be scared all the time, right? Because that's where it started for me. Like, I've been aware of the spirit world all my life, and I'm really lucky because I was raised by Gary Douglas, who is a fucking incredible man. And he is the founder of Access Consciousness, and he always encouraged me to be aware of what I was aware of. He never made me wrong for seeing invisible people walking down the hall and, you know, but it was one thing to like talk about the spirit world around my dining room table, which we actually did a lot. But then it was another thing to go out into the world and realize that, like, if I talked about, you know, seeing a dead person like sitting on a sofa, that most people would judge me. So I knew that that was also going on in the world around me. And so as a teen, I like did my best to shut it off by using drugs, overeating, forcing it out of existence, all of which didn't work. It just made me worse, and it made me suicidal. Because what occurs with spirit capabilities is if you don't acknowledge you're talking to entities or dealing with entities or aware of entities, you sort of distort your perception into depression, anxiety, social paranoia, schizophrenia, bipolar, etc. So by the time I was 18, I was really unhappy and I was extremely suicidal. And Gary had been sort of simultaneously doing more and more access. Like, he started access when I was 12. And then I didn't really do much of it because it was just this thing my dad was doing. But then by the time I was 18, I was like, I'm going to die or I need to do something different. So he like tricked me into getting my bars run, which is one of the foundational processes of access. And that started really turning things around for me. I actually started feeling happy again for the first time. And then when I was 21, the light bulb switched on again and all the spirits came back, because I had made a commitment to like being myself when I was 21, which I really, looking back now, that's a pretty cool thing for a 21-year-old to do, you know? I had made this, like, I had been in art school. My mom like wanted me to go to college. I had no choice about it. I had to do something. So I chose art school and I hated it because I really didn't want to go to college. And I went to art school and I dropped out of one and I went to another and then I dropped out of that one. Finally, I was like, I don't really want to do this. I want to do access. And so I dropped out of art school and I moved back to Santa Barbara, where I'm from, and was living in my first apartment as an adult for the first time in my life. And I was in this tiny apartment, you know, in Southern California. And literally one day, the living room in the apartment filled with so many ghosts that I couldn't see the other side of the room. And I knew it was entities. And I freaked out. I went into total reaction. And I immediately called my dad and I was like, oh my God, my house is so full of ghosts. I'm so freaked out. And he's like, that's great. You know, he was really positive about it. And I was like, fuck this. I hate this. This is creepy. This is weird. Make this stop. And so I shut the door. I like really forced it to stop. And then over the next 3 to 4 months, my whole life just got worse and worse and worse. I didn't feel good. I felt really lost. I like couldn't make any money. It was just not going well. And I was out at dinner at my parents' house one night and I'm complaining to my dad in the kitchen. I was like, my life sucks, blah, blah, blah. And he's like, well, what did you refuse to do? And I was like, oh, I refused to talk to the entities. And I saw in that moment how refusing something that was a natural ability and capacity was going to kill me. So I said yes to talk to the entities, even though it wasn't called talk to the entities at that point. I said yes, even though I had no idea what it would look like. And wow, am I fucking stoked I said yes, because what is this? 20 years later, it's talk to the entities has changed and saved so many people's lives. There's over 150 international facilitators who speak over 35 languages. There's 2 books. It's this thriving organism in the universe that reminds people that like spirit awareness is natural. And here are all the tools to use to make it work for us in the spirit world. And so when I learned this stuff, since I didn't really have ancestors, it was sort of like it never really occurred to me until I think I went to India for the first time. And then came the ancestors. And I was like, oh, this is a thing? Like, you guys actually want your ancestors around. Like, because I had just grown up sort of like clearing entities, facilitating them to move on, creating with the ones that I could cooperate with. There was never really this like ancestral worship thing that happened. And so I've had to learn in Mexico, in India, in Asia, a lot in Japan about how to respect the ancestor culture. Because the ancestors, well, sorry, I jumped too many tracks. So this is the thing. Would an infinite being have a family? If you were born and taken away on day one and raised by some other family and no one ever told you, would you ever know the difference? So family is conceptual. It's an idea we have. It's not a reality. Our families share a genetic, our bodies share a genetic family, but we as the being don't have family. So when your body dies, do you still have a family? You don't even really have a family now. You just pretend like you do. How many of you guys would like to be alleviated from being part of your family? Right, wrong, good, bad, all nine, pod, punctures, boys, and beyonds. And so when it comes to the ancestor thing, it's like, I don't really think that it's any different. It's like, I think we treat our ancestors the same way we treat our family. It's like, are your families, now don't get mad at me, I'm going to say this to free a few of you. I love the family conversation. If you feel defensive, feel free to close your computer. Is your family about empowerment, freedom of choice, and allowance? Or has your family been a source of judgment and limitation for you? What's your priority? Judgment, limitation, or freedom and possibility? And so this is like where you need to also take this into the spirit world. It's like, why would you want to keep your ancestors around after they walked out of their bodies? My point of view is like, this isn't even a point of view. This is just what is. We all have free will and we all have choice. When your body dies, what choice would you like to make? You know, are you going to hang around to take care of your family or to control your family or to be part of your family? Is that enough for you? And is that enough for your ancestors? So all of your ancestors that would like to leave now, let's do this. Let's revoke, recant, rescind, renounce, denounce, destroy, and create all your commitments, oaths, vows, fealties, community swearings, binding and bonding contracts that you made to them and that they made to you and the family throughout any and all lifetimes, dimensions, and realities, including all the shaky parts and pieces. Destroy and uncreate all that. Right, wrong, good, bad, all nine. Woohoo! Pod, poc, shorts, boys, and beyonds. Now, truth, who are all of you? Truth, who were you all before that? Truth, who were you all before that? Truth, who will you be in the future? I don't believe in family. I believe in choice and I believe in free will. And I think that keeping the ancestors around is, it's like, it's one thing if it's their choice. It's one thing if you're needy. And if you're needy towards a spirit, that binds and bonds them to this world and doesn't allow them to move on. So it's a different point of view. It's a different way of looking at ancestral things. It's a different way of looking at family, period. You know? So thank you all so much for joining. Trust yourself. Bye.
Thank you for listening to this show. My target is to make consciousness easy to find and choose. So if you enjoyed this podcast, please leave a 5-star review on iTunes and share this with somebody who you know who might be looking for more consciousness in their life. You can visit me on shannon-o'hara.com or talktotheentities.com. And to learn more about the amazing tools of Access Consciousness, you can visit accessconsciousness.com and be sure to subscribe to the podcast.